Today we're going to do the unboxing of the mini bug box with side door and the giant bog jumping spider called Servaea incana. Your jumping spider will arrive in a foil wrapped container that we like to call the comfy cup. You will receive your jumping spider in a comfy cup. It will have the name of the species, in this case, a giant bark jumping spider. It's called Servaea incana. As you can see, it's running around there. Now, the brown stuff you see over here is moss. We wet it and put it in a little net that we glue on so that the spider has some hydration during its travels. Then we also add some tissue paper for it to hold onto something so it doesn't get bounced around during shipment. Now, before we take our spider out, we need to set up our enclosure. Today we have the mini bug box with side door. It comes with everything that you'll need to keep your spider. It will have a piece of bark, a bark hide, some fake plants, a little sachet of scoria, or bring your own water bowl, and some coco peat substrate. You'll start off by putting the substrate into the bottom of the container. Keep in mind that your jumper will probably only go to the ground when it needs to eat. The rest of the time it will probably be hiding in the bark or at the top of the enclosure. Now, if you've ordered our cube enclosure, it will come with the same items inside, except that the bark hide would obviously be a bit smaller. Once you've firmed down coco peat a little bit, you will then go ahead and place your bark hide inside. Now you want to make sure that it doesn't flop left and right when you put it in, so that when the container gets tipped like this, you don't want it flopping around and accidentally crushing your spider. The next thing you can do is maybe add some of your plants. There we go. And lastly, you want to add your scoria to a little water bowl. What we normally use is the lid of a milk bottle top or anything else that's quite shallow. You will be placing these little scoria rocks inside the bowl, if you can pretend my hand is a bowl, and then you'll be misting or watering these little rocks only. This will ensure that the spider or its prey, like the crickets, when they accidentally hop into the water bowl, they don't drown. They can still climb out. Found myself a little milk carton top, and I'll be placing this bowl in the enclosure. Your enclosure is now ready for your spider. Another thing you want to check before you put your spider in is occasionally we have a little gap in the door, usually about 2 mils. This particular one doesn't have a gap. But occasionally we do have a gap here, and you need to check that your spider is not small enough to get through this little gap. That can happen, and if you are concerned, you can just tape a little piece of tape over here to secure it and make sure it doesn't escape. All right, so now the fun can start. We can try and put our little new jumping spider into its enclosure. Now you want to be careful when you open the container, making sure you know exactly where your spider is at all times so you don't squish him by accident. And the safest to get him into the enclosure is always to open the lid very slowly. There he is. Now he'll be keen to come out, so if you hold your finger there, they normally like to jump on. Come, little guy. Oh, he missed. Let's try again. I remember a jumping spider will almost always jump up rather than down. Once you have him, you'll be happy to be in there. There he goes. And straight to the top, of course. He loves his little piece of bark. Now, for the care of this little jumping spider, you would need to spray it at least twice a week. I normally spray only the sides and not the bark. You don't want the bark to go all moldy. And always make sure that your little scoria rocks in your water bottle is always wet. Now, to try and figure out what kind of size cricket your spider will need, you would need to look at its body size. This means it's not including the legs. And you would imagine a cricket about the third of the size of the spider's body. That is the cricket size that you will need to feed it. Normally with Servaea incana, they take extra small crickets unless they're really small juvies. Now this is quite a large juvie, so he will still be taking extra small crickets. If you have any more questions, please feel free to drop us an email or send us a message. We're happy to answer any questions you may have.